What's up, guys? Welcome to Jordan Michael Fishing. It's overcast today. The snakeheads should be out. They should be nice and active. They're not having to hide from the birds and all that stuff, so we're gonna hit it hard. We got three different rods we're taking. I'm using, you know, variety of baits. I show you guys out in the water what I'm using. So we're gonna be in this kayak here. But anyways, thank you guys for watching. See you out in the water. Stay tuned. So this whole pond here had no water in it yesterday, 2 days ago. And what happens is it busts down there at the beach. So, but anyways, we're gonna try to get on some snakeheads. We're gonna try to get on some snakeheads out here, see what's going on. This is really just a test run for tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm hitting this place super hard if I see movement. But for now, we're just gonna hit up, go up in these coves here, go down by that shoreline, cast all through that shoreline, and see what happens. It's so windy out here. It's really not a good fishing day. But we use the wind in our, into our favor.
On this weed line, guys.
Now I'm using the black Booyah popping frog at the moment. It was fine when it just got out of here, but now you see, it's just instant. Instant wind, and it is, like, I mean, it is blowing fast. If them pappas grass wasn't there, I'd be going down river.
See that, guys?
And I could grab this bird just about. Look at this thing, guys. What's up, buddy? Go that way. God, bird. Awful friendly. Alright, I'm gonna hit the beach real quick. We're gonna come back. I'm gonna hit this. either starting or hit the surface.
Unfortunately, not too much went on down there on the beach, so we're back up at the pond now. But just to let you guys know, that's where this pond leads to. It leads to a small stream, and it runs all the way down to where that opening just was when I was fishing on the beach. He missed it once, he came back after it the second time, he missed it again, but kind of brought it down underneath the water, and you wait a couple seconds, you set the hook. Nothing else I could do there.
I'm so over these frogs, man.
At that time, that fish did not miss whatsoever. I felt it, I waited a couple seconds, set the hook, had him on for about 5 or 6 cranks, boom, nothing.
Throwing on a whopper plopper, a mouse whopper plopper. See what happens.
If they're not connected with your topwater hollow body frogs, throw on a hard body with some treble hooks. See what happens. The only problem with that is when snakehead fishing, they're usually in grassy areas, so it's hard to use a whopper plopper most of the time because you just get caught up on all the grass with your treble hooks. So
how does that look?
Huge blow up. Man, I don't even have a net. I do not recommend doing this without a net because there is 6 hooks attached to that lure that will literally go through your hand in all different directions. This is why you need a net, guys. That's why you need a net, guys. Also, forgot my lip grippers. So, no net, no lip grippers. Yeah, I can't believe I even caught
that
fish.
Exactly where I was caught.
That is insane that I was able to catch that fish. It was a lot of luck.
Alright, let's get these rods out of the way first. I cannot believe I wasn't recording that. I mean, you just cannot record every single second. This is already GoPro 3.
We got one! Woohoo!
Got him off the hook. He actually broke the treble hook. Be all right. I got another treble hook right here. Brand new ones. Damn. Bad boys. That's my, hold up. I got another whopper pup. No, I don't. Not with me. So I said, man, I said, look, I'm getting all these hits. Top water, nothing with the chatterbait, nothing with. I mean, I was getting all the hits with that frog, man, but just could not get it. Just that's how you catch one without a net, guys. It is a pain in the ass. I got all the way over here. cleaned my truck out. Got all the way over here. No lip grippers or net. That's how you catch one. That's how you catch one old fashioned. When the bite picks up, it usually picks up too. It has picked up within the past hour and a half. So guys, what I was doing was I saw that bird over there. So I said, look, I'm not gonna mess with over there right now. So I came over here. Let me back up some. So I came over here and I was, you know, instead of casting the shoreline, I switched to a whopper plopper instead of the black frog. And I just cast it up like this. And I was bringing it back. And when I was keeping that rod tip high up in the air to keep that mouse, keep his nose out of the water, make it look like a real mouse, you know? And he, I was about right there. And he smashed. He smashed it. That was fun. Look at that. See that? Look at that snakehead. Look at that snakehead. You guys see that? Yeah, they're feeding now. Did you guys see that snakehead jump out of the water? I know I did. All I'm doing. Yes! Woohoo! Here guys, I'm gonna show you the fish. Nice fish. Like I said guys, it's just a start. So, it's a beautiful area here. He's a nice one. Probably about three to four pounds. I would say about 24 inches. But yeah, he's a nice one. But that'll do it for this one. Whew, I'm tired. Been out there for like at least 6 hours. We got one. Got a whole bunch of bites. I'm just scouting this place out. We'll get it right once I figure out what they're smashing on, what they're eating. We'll get it right, guys. So, anyways, please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching.